it's clear that year after year, the BMC and the administration has simply not done their job. But are they the only ones to actually blame? Does some blame actually lie on the ordinary Mumbaikar's door as well? The BMC asks very rightly, who is to blame if lives are lost in spite of high tide alerts and evacuation notices? The people counter question, where are they to go on such short-term notices? This is an argument between the people of Mumbai and the administration.
Monsoon terror on the rise. 8 lives lost as a wall collapsed in the Gyaneshwar Nagar area of Thane Wednesday morning. Several chuggis around the area were damaged because of the collapse.
We're right now standing in Gyaneshwar Nagar in Thane, and the first heavy rain of the season has brought in calamity in Thane. This wall just caved in the early part of the morning, killing 8 people and injuring 7. You can see that there's a digger which is right over here. It has taken out all the people. Those who were trapped have been removed. They have been admitted to a civil hospital in Thane, and all of them are said to be safe and sound. This is a construction site, and a locality is located just next to it. The administration is ensuring that no such incidents happen in the future, and that is the reason why the walls which are there nearby to the area are just being cleared off. They are just being taken down so that it doesn't happen in the future.
A landslide was also reported from another part of the city. The wall of a BMC school collapsed in Shaunagar. Even after continuous warnings and notification from the BMC, Mumbaikars continue to reside in so-called danger zones. Has Mumbai become immune to the havoc played by monsoons year after year?
It is just the fault of the implementing machinery. The entire system is completely taken over by the system of contractors. Then it's a systemic failure of these agencies. And
why are these areas not being evacuated despite all the notices issued by the authorities? Have Mumbaikars become callous, or does the truth lie elsewhere? This is Kurla's Jayamari suburb. It is here that 6 people were crushed in a landslide last monsoon. But little has been done to protect the residents from another disaster. The BMC on its part has sent out notices to residents alerting them that they live in danger zones and that they should evacuate these areas during the monsoon.
हम नहीं लेंगे उनको हम कहेंगे कि यहाँ पर उनका रहना धोखादायक है और यहाँ पर उनको नहीं रह सकते।
127 danger zones have been sent notices of evacuation. But is that a solution to the problem? Do alternative arrangements figure anywhere in the BMC's list of concerns?
We are having one of the victims from last year who lost 3 of their family members in the incident.
आप ये बताइए कि अभी जब BMC ने आपको notice दिया तो आपको कोई दूसरी जगह भी बताई?
नहीं बताई है. बोली कि मैं notice दे रहा हूँ. इसके बाद मेरी guarantee नहीं है. यहाँ पे किसी को कुछ हो ना हो. बस मेरा यही जवाबदारी है. वहाँ से आर्डर है कि ये नोटिस दे के आओ. बस इतना बोल के गए. हम लोग बोले भी कि हम लोग कहाँ जाएंगे जब हमारे बच्चे पढ़ने लिखने वाले हैं, बड़े बड़े हो चुके हैं. हम लोग कहाँ जाएंगे? बोले कि बारिश भर तुम लोग कहीं भी रहो, उसके बाद में रहो.
With rapid expansion of the maximum city, the warning bells are tolling loud and clear. Lack of urban planning, unprecedented rains, and the failure of the early warning system are some of the important factors for the yearly tragedy that has been striking Mumbai.
The larger problem still remains unanswered. With nowhere else to go, these people continue to live in danger. A landslide can crush them anytime. A wall can collapse and kill any number of people on any given day. And all that the BMC can do is point to the notice and say, we told you so. With Rahul Mahajani and Aditya Aman, Pankaj Upadhyay in Mumbai for Headlines Today.